Good morning. It's Nancy today. Well, Willem and I have gone to the temple. We hadn't really planned on it. Life was going along according to normal. But I had this impression that I really should go, that I should be in the temple. And so I said, Willem, do you want to go today? I was out doing an errand. Okay, and so by the time I got back, he was already, and I just had to go grab my bag, and then we came, and I had the most wonderful experience. which is, I don't know what my challenge is doing right now. Sometimes the more involved we are in the community and in work and with people, organizations, the more our challenges are. But at the same time, the more our blessings can be. Don't you agree?
Yeah.
He agrees, so I must be right. Faith precedes the miracle. It's a really powerful statement. Not just faith in anything, faith in Jesus Christ. Well, I guess faith in anything also, but faith precedes the miracle. It also precedes being able to see the miracle. And you know what? Faith makes miracles happen. Somebody was saying the other day that when they're in a really bad mood, they try not to go out because if they're feeling really negative, they will draw negative people to themselves. And I think in a way that's related to faith preceding the miracle. Sort of in as a man thinketh, so is he. What a strange looking car. Must be a very, very old car. And there's a line in philosophy, something about when you're looking for something, that's what you'll see. I can't remember how it's phrased.
Very profound.
Very profound, yes. But it's actually used when our teenagers talk to us. It's actually used to cut down our faith. To say that this isn't real, it's only real because you think it's real, and so then you find more evidence to support your claim. But, you know, if you feel negative and you're out there being negative everywhere, you'll find a lot of people are negative. If you dislike something, you adamantly dislike bad drivers or harsh drivers, then you notice a lot of harsh drivers. Like there's one right there. We'll see blue flashy lights behind him a little later. Whatever you're looking for, the more you'll see. But if you're looking for God, if you're looking for godliness, there's a blue flashing light right there. Did you get that guy, or has he already got somebody else? Oh, that guy's lucky. The police are busy. They don't notice.
Yes, they're at a different car.
That will cause him to slow down. So he won't get caught, which is good. Which is good that he won't have to pay a lot of money, but maybe, blah, 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 blah.
All right, that's the most profound thing.
What?
That's the most profound thing.
It's the most profound thing I've said so far.
No. I'm just teasing.
I love my mother. He's a good dude. He's the dude and I'm the dudette. Anyway, I had more to say on that subject, but you know, you can imagine what it is, so I don't need to say it.
Hey, I just turn on your iPod and say, that's your day. And I say, goodbye. Because they'll know what you normally say. Is that what you say?
Yeah. Huh. You know what I'm thinking, right? These are very big raindrops that are falling. Would you like to watch the raindrops fall? Okay, I'll turn you around. Goodbye.